से तो भालू
चुका है। हरे कृष्णा, कृष्णा, हरे हरे, हरे राम,
राम हरे हरे।
आज एक विशेष तिथि है, पंजाब भक्ति वेदांत नारायण महाराज का आगे दूसरे अर्थ मौनी अमावस्या वैष्णव का आगे जन ही बराबर पूज्य। लेकिन आविर्भाव से तिरुभाव तिथि ज्यादा महत्वयुक्त है, क्योंकि पहले तो कोई जानता नहीं, उस वक्त तो प्रकाश ही तो हुआ नहीं, बाद में ही होता है। तब वैष्णव का आचरण समझना मुश्किल है, मुश्किल है। उन्होंने जब किसी कारण बस वहाँ मथुरा में एक गोवर्धन में रहा था, तो उस वक्त मुझको पत्र लिखा था, कोई उज्जवल नीलमणि भक्ति रसामृत सिंधु, उस वक्त आउट ऑफ प्रिंट था, पुराना दुकान से संग्रह करके भेजा था। ऐसा ही वो बाद में जब आया था वहाँ वृंदावन में, वृंदावन में विशेष काम था इसलिए वृंदावन में आया था, तब ज्यादा ये हुआ परिचय घनिष्ठ हुआ। और वहाँ गया था तो उन्होंने उनसे मैंने बोला इनको मैं पहले ही जानता था, जब प्रचार में गया था हैदराबाद में, उस वक्त सरस्वती होटल में वो लोग खाया था सिकंदराबाद, तो उनका पत्रिका में एक लोगों का प्रतिवाद किया था, इन्होंने बोला था, क्या बोला था, कोई भक्त ये जो लोग कृष्ण भजन करेगा वही स्वर्ग में जाएगा, और कृष्ण भजन जो ना करेगा ये सब नरक में जाएगा। तो उसका एक या ये बातों का सिद्धांत है, ऐसा बात। तब मैंने और वहां का मोट इंसान दोनों किया, कोई होटल में जाकर के मिला, वो भक्त शरीर छोड़ दिया, एक्सीडेंट हुआ जब एयरपोर्ट में जा रहा, तो उन्होंने वो वहां था परिचय, मैं नहीं जाना। तो ये लोग जो बोला बात तो ठीक ही है, लेकिन इसमें थोड़ा इजी कर दिया, जानते देव प्रताप देवान पिछली जानती पिछित्रता भूता में जानती भूते जानती मोजादी नौकरी माओ, जो जिनका भजन करेगा वो वही जाएगा। तो सब तो बराबर हो गया, ये बराबर नहीं। अंतमान तो फलम तेसा तब भगवती अल्पमे दशा, ये लोगों का जो फल है ये अंतमान नाशवान, इसलिए वो लोग अल्पमेधा, अल्पमेधा यदि बोले तो इसमें सबको बुरा लगता है, क्योंकि संस्कृत भाषा अत्यंत मार्जित तो गाली भी को थोड़ा ही, लेकिन यदि इसका अर्थ किया जाए अल्पमेधा, और इसको यदि बोले हिंदी में बुड़बक, इंग्लिश में स्टूपिड, तब गुस्सा होगा। अरे अल्पमेध होता है गुस्सा होगा। तो इस बात को ठीक ही बोला, ये ना होना से ये नरक में जाएगा, ये बात सच्ची, ऐसा बात एक बार के वो पत्रिका में उसका उत्तर दिया। उन्होंने एक रामानुजीय वैष्णव हरि प्रसाद मयूर उनका आतिथ्य में था, वही था जैसा भी परिचय कर दिया मैंने महिला। बाद में एक महाराज वो वहां देश में किया, उससे आस्ते आस्ते प्रचार किया। जब पहले था उन्होंने प्रचार पार्टी का लीड करते, उसके बाद जो बामन महाराज इन्होंने पार्टी में जाता, इन्होंने लीड करते सब लोगों को जाना ले जाना कथा बोलना। बाद में हमारा परम पूज्य श्रीमान भक्ति प्रज्ञान ये सब गोस्वामी महाराज इन्होंने प्रतिवाद बड़ा जबरदस्त कर दिया। जैसे एक एक भागों में लोग एकदम गुस्सा हो जाता, भीते बोला किसी बात निम्बार को बोल के कोई संप्रदाय है नहीं, निम्बार को कोई संप्रदाय नहीं, शास्त्र में नहीं निम्बार, लेकिन नाम निम्बार को नहीं निम्बार भित्य आस्ते आस्ते इसमें इसी में अभी था। वृंदावन में भी जब सब चला गया, गौरी मठ का सब बड़ा बड़ा महात्मा सब चला गया, उस वक्त पहले जो प्रतिवाद किया था उसको दोबारा उठाया, कौन उठाया, सामला धाकी, वो इसका जो ग्रंथ है चैतन्य चैतन्य राधा गोविंद नाथ, जिन्होंने अंडरटेकिंग दिया था 5 साल कोर्ट में, ये हमारा गलती हुआ ऐसा। उसी बात को ये लोग उठाया कहा भाई पूज्य बात नारायण महाराज इसको प्रतिवाद किया पुराणों को लेकर के एक छोटा से ग्रंथ प्रकाशित किया नाम दिया प्रबंध पंचकम और इसको बिना मूल्य में वितरण ऐसा ऐसा जब उसने वो लोग थोड़ा बहुत बात बोला तो बोला ये जो ना गौरी मठ का गुरु परंपरा ठीक नहीं गौरी मठ जो बोला था जो जिन्होंने ये बात बोला नाथ महाशय उनका गुरु कौन है उन्होंने तो किसी का गुरु माना नहीं तब गुरु परंपरा उनका कौन सा गुरु परंपरा ऐसा बोल के यदि आ जाए तो इसको विचार किया जाएगा तो फिर आज आया नहीं तो बात होता है भगत भगत और ऐसा होता टाइम में भी ऐसा आया पुराना गौड़ियों यदि कोई पढ़ गया तो देखा जाएगा चारों तरफ से जीरो गौड़ीय मठ विश्व निंदो अरे गौड़ीय मठ में मठ का प्रचार ऐसा निर्भीक भाव से प्रथम जीवन में नारायण महाराज अशुष्ट करे प्रचार नहीं कर जयपुर में सत्येंद्र भान चतुर्वेदी भक्ता का यहाँ गौड़ीय मठ का कोई प्रचार नहीं और कोई जो ये था अभी भी है वो पहले मठवासी था बाद में जाकर गृहस्थ बना उन्होंने बोला यहाँ हिंदी भाषा भाषी के लिए कोई ये नहीं कई महाराज अस्वस्थ रहते थे इनको मैं कोलकाता में डॉक्टर दिखाया डॉक्टर का नाम है एना सेनगुप्त उन्होंने उनको देखा और उनका जो डिसेंट्री था बराबर बार बार जाने पड़ता था इसलिए कहाँ जाता था तो उनका उन्होंने चावल खिलाया कच्चा कला सिद्ध दही का सा ऐसा मैं औषध दिया उनमें ठीक हो उसका बाद से ही एक एक ग्रंथ को कोई प्रचार किया पहले वही इसको हिंदी में बनाते थे तस्करी का भागवत तो दूसरी बाद में हुआ वही जैव धर्म को मनाया ऐसा एक एक बनाने के बाद विदेश में जाके विशेष प्रचार किया तो बात होता है आचरण से ही प्रचार होता है विदेश जाने से ही प्रचार हो जाएगा ये बात हजारों जो भजन कोई ग्रहण करेगा आचरण जिनका होगा उन उनसे ही ये लोग एक करेगा जैसे वही विचार इस में से बहुत घनिष्ठ था इसीलिए हमारा बंधु स्थानीय व्यक्ति बोले तो ठीक होगा एक वास्तव वर्ष में बांधव बांधव किसको बोलते है उत्सवे व्यसने जैव दुर्भिक्षे राष्ट्र विप्लवी राजोद्दारे स्वसाने जगकृष्ट होती सबंधव उत्सव में शामिल उत्सव में आ जाते जब असुविधा हो असुस्थ उस वक्त भी साथ है दुर्भिक्ष हो जब देश में अकाल पड़ेगा उस वक्त भी साथ देना রাষ্ট্র বিপ্লবের পাকিস্তান ইন্ডিয়া বনা এইসব ক্ষেত্র মে যে রাজত্বকারী যাব রাজত্বের মে পুলিশ পকড় কে লে যায়গা উসকো সাথে আর শশানি তো যাব শরীর ত্যাগ করতা হ্যায় উসকো কাছে ইসমে জো বন্ধু রাষ্ট্র হ্যায় উসমে সবই আতা হ্যায় উসকো লিয়ে কিসি কো লাভ দেতা হ্যায় देव तो सब राष्ट्र का लोग आएगा तो उसको ऐसे हिसाब से ही नहीं जब जरूरत पड़ता है हमारा काली अल्लाह मठ में इन्होंने ब्रह्मचारी भेजा और एक किया सब से जाकर के जबरदस्ती बंगड़ी दिलाया गिरि महाराज जी का तिरुभा तिथि में जो उत्सव होता है उन्होंने वहां और सामना ऐसा उस वक्त महाराज नहीं था इन्होंने किया उसका बाद ही इन्होंने इस वक्त उन्होंने बोला था जब एक उनका एक किया था क्या क्या था नाम घर में कुछ नहीं था बचना पाया उनका वहां होती थी इनको सेवा करना तो चिड़िया को झगड़ा करके एक इतना से कपड़ा का टुकड़े वहां सुआ चारना था उसमें से एक किया तो उस वक्त तो गिरी महाराज उनको जैसा भी हो दूसरी है हम लोग सब लोग को खिलाकर उन्होंने हमारा गुरु महाराज को आदर्श दिया कुछ नारायण बाबा सबको खिला के खाना उन्होंने भी उत्सव में सबको खिलाने के बाद ही वो प्रसाद लेके बाद नारायण महाराज भी ऐसे एक दो बार हुआ भक्ति का अपन दामोदर महाराज वहां जाकर के हाजिर हुआ उन्होंने आज मैं बाकी है प्रसाद पाने के लिए केशव जी गौड़ी मठ में उनका जो कमरा था वो ही वहां तब उन्होंने बोला आप प्रसाद पा लीजिए हमारे आने में देर हो गई देर किस बात की तो उन्होंने बोला ये आया इनको ले कर के ये तो बोले मैं भी रह जाता हूँ इसमें भी ये था जैसा जैसा है वैष्णव सेवा में आदर्श देखा जाए सब कुछ प्रसाद लिया एक साथ में हम तीन लिया थोड़ा से वो गुस्सा कर जाते लेकिन उनमें उनसे दूसरी बात है उन्होंने जब कोई धर्म सभा वगैरह होते थे तब वहाँ हाजिर होते तो जब संत महाराज का वहाँ हुआ तो हम लोग वहाँ जाकर मैं भी गया तो वहाँ यूनिवर्सिटी का प्रतिष्ठा था जिन्होंने मायावादी विचार पसंद करते, उन्होंने बोला सब ब्रह्म, जीव सब ब्रह्म, ब्रह्म का तो कोई स्वीकार नहीं, तो उसको समझाया वो सुनेगा नहीं कोई बात। उनका नाम था ध्यानेश नारायण चक्रवर्ती, वो तो बात सुनेंगे। लास्ट में मजबूर संतुष्ट वो क्या किया, हाथ में दंड लेकर उनको मुक्त का मार्ग दे दिया। जब दिया उन्होंने थोड़ा पीछे किया और किया आप थोड़ा पीछे और किया और थोड़ा पीछे पीछे गया। उन्होंने बोला आप ब्रह्म नहीं है, आपको विकार देखता हूं, मैं दुबला पतला आदमी हूं, आपको मुक्का लगाया है और आप इससे भयभीत हो गया और आप बोलते मैं ब्रह्म हूं, तो बच्चा से हास पड़े, तो शर्मिंदा हो गया। मैं मोटा आदमी नहीं दुबला, उससे ही भय अपना, और आप ब्रह्म है इसी में नारायण महाराज सब अटेंड करते थे, उनका मत की तरफ से उन्होंने ही ब्रजमंडल या ब्रजमंडल परिक्रमा में आया तो कुछ दिन हमारा वहाँ ठहरेंगे। उस वक्त वो लोगों का कुछ मौत बना नहीं, तो वहाँ पत्र भेजा थी, तो गुरु जी उनमें उत्तर में बोला ये यहाँ, लेकिन एक बात है यहाँ दो अमून जलेगा, आप लोगों को हमारे साथ महिला क्यों करने पड़ेगा, जैसे हम लोग साकान्न भोग लगाता हूँ ठाकुर जी को, मुझे आदोष रही महाराज जी ने बड़ा इसलिए दिया नहीं था बस, और हम लोगों को बोला ये थोड़ा अच्छा व्यवस्था करना, अपने वैष्णव का वैराग्य करने देना, नारायण महाराज जी भी ऐसा दोष देखा उन्होंने किया और शेष में रहना ऐसा देखा हो। आज उनका तिथि में उनका कृपा प्रार्थना करता हूँ, उन्होंने भी ऐसा बताया और ऐसा बोला हरिद्वार में, हमारा दो तीन ब्रह्मचारी किया था, उन्होंने उस वक्त यही बात को दोहराया, ये लोग ऐसा ये करते हैं वो लोग यहाँ रसोई करके खाएगा शर्म नहीं आता, ऐसा बोल के जबरदस्त ही फेंक दिया। ऐसा भी जला दिया, लेकिन उन्होंने नेत्रिक अशुष्ट शरीर में भी इतना रिस्क लेकर विदेश में जाके प्रचार किया, इधर तो अशुष्ट था, बाद में सब जाएगा में गया, मुझको बोला मैं वहां अच्छा रहता हूं, विदेश में जाकर वहां अच्छा रहे, यहां से वहां अच्छा रहे, बाद में प्रचार कर लो, उन्होंने ये किया। माठ नवद्दीन ने किया, गोवर्धन में किया, जहां कोई गोवर्धन में उन्होंने रहा था। ये शिव मंदिर है, उस शिव मंदिर अभी भी है, वहां ही कोई जमीन लेकर के वहीं मठ बनाया। पुराना आदमी को याद होगा, उन्होंने एक पुराना मकान में दो मंजिल में ऊपर में रहते थे, तो वही वहां एक मठ बनाया। इसमें भी जगह जगह में मठ बनाकर और वही आदर्श दिया हमारा गुरुदेव का, कोई मठ बड़ा बनाना, वो छोटा नहीं बनाना। तो वहां रहने के लिए नहीं, हम लोग गोष्ठानंदी है, जो सब लोग आएगा ये सबको लेकर ही वहां रहेंगे, और सबको लेकर उत्सव आदि करना एकत्र मिलकर। इसे मैंने किया था विशाखापट्टनम, विशाखापट्टनम में किया, उन्होंने पाटिल देकर आया था, मैं गया था कुछ बात पूरी गुस्से में महाराज ऐसा वहां जाके, तो मेरा सुन के बड़ा सुख हुआ। जब मंगलाचरण शुरू किया तब ये तमिल, तेलुगु, हिंदी, उड़िया, बांग्ला, विभिन्न भाषा भाषी जो साधु महात्मा था सभी वही एक ही मंत्र बोलने लगा। उस वक्त ये नहीं सुन के बोलेगा नहीं, सभी बोलने लगा मंगलाचरण। वहां आए थे मेयर, उनका सभापति मनाया था, तो वो स्थान का नाम था जहां उत्सव किया उन्होंने, उस स्थान का नाम है लेसन्स बे। मैंने मेयर को रिक्वेस्ट किया था कि इनको कृष्णनगर बना दीजिए, वैसे जो मठ बना कृष्णनगर में मठ है इनको राधानगर बनाओ, तो बोला था मैं कोशिश करूंगा। बाद में मैंने सुना जब वहां वो कृष्णनगर राधानगर बना, और इस वक्त मैं बोला था देश को राधा नगर बना दो, लेसन्स बे क्यों रहेगा। बाद में वहां से आए थे हमारा, जब ये लोग आएंगे वो लोगों का आदर्श गुरुदेव का आदर्श लेकर के मैंने पहले आगे आएगी दी थी वहां से, और मठ में ये लोगों का रहने के लिए अरेंजमेंट किया। उन्होंने नारायण महाराज जी ने बोला कि मैं तो मठ में रह सकता हूँ लेकिन मेरा जो शरीर है उसमें तकलीफ होगा, किसी को बस गिर जा सकता, और अटैच बाथरूम नहीं। तो मैंने बोला हमारा मठ में तो है, वहां रहो, तो हमारा मठ में कृपा करके अवस्था न किया। उस वक्त उनका सेवक था अभी जो माधव महाराज बना, नवीन कृष्ण, नवीन कृष्ण उनका सेवक, वही वही पुरुषोत्तम महीना में उन्होंने तीन दफा वहां रहा, एक दफा हमारा मठ में, एक दफा सिंघानिया का वहां, और एक दो भाई के डॉक्टर का वो जो बनाया मकान वहां बना। बर्तन वगैरह हमारा मठ से ही जाता था, तो उन्होंने ये किया, क्या किया, जब जाते थे दर्शन में उस रोज मुझको साथ में ले जाते, ले जाते तो छोटा कोपिनाथ में व्यवस्था हुआ, नरसिंह मंदिर में भी हुआ, अलगोरनाथ में भी हुआ, ऐसा जगह में जाते। जब वहां हुआ उस वक्त क्या हुआ, छोटा गोपीनाथ में उनका जो गुरु भ्रा का देश का गुरु भ्रा का नाम है त्रिविक्रम महाराज, उन्होंने बोला ये सब करके कुछ फायदा नहीं, मैंने बहुत किया, गोल मंडल क्षेत्र मंडल नवद्वीप मंडल ब्रज मंडल सब परिक्रमा किया, कुछ हुआ नहीं, ऐसा बेकार ऐसा बोला। तो उन्होंने क्या बोले,
एक बात बोला,
इन्होंने ब्रज में रहते हैं का रोटी हम लोग को बोली लोगों का नहीं, ऐसा बोला। तो उन्होंने मुझको बोला आप कुछ बोलो, तो मैं नहीं उनको आप बोला क्या बोला था, ये यही जो बोला कि हमारा कुछ हुआ नहीं, इनका दो अर्थ होता है, साधारण अर्थ में हमके कुछ हुआ नहीं, और दूसरी अर्थ में जिनका बहुत हुआ वो भी पूछता है हमारा कुछ हुआ। जैसे रूप गोस्वामी बोला क्या बोला, इसका मतलब रूप गोस्वामी का कुछ हुआ नहीं, ये अपराध का कूड़ा दान है, यदि ना हो तो उन्होंने झूठ बोला, कौन सा देवगी ये झूठ बोला, नहीं तो ये अपराधी है, किसको बात को देंगे। कविराज गोस्वामी बोला पूरी से गीत हुई थे मुई से लोभिष्ट जगाई माधाई हुई थी मुई से पापिष्ट, मोर नाम जे लय तार पुण्य क्षय, आज मोर नाम जे सुने तार पाप। तो यदि ऐसा ही है चले उनको लेना नहीं तो कविराज गोस्वामी झूठ बोला नाम नहीं लेना, क्या करेंगे। ऐसा तो वहां बहुत उदाहरण दिया। सनातन गोस्वामी बोला ये मैं इतना मूर्ख है कि मैं अपना परिचय जानता नहीं, इसने तो पूछा मैं कौन हूं। आपने तुम तो कर्नाटक देशी हो, भरद्वाज गोत्रीय ब्राह्मण, हुसैन शाह बादशाह का प्राइम मिनिस्टर, अरबी फारसी संस्कृत बांग्ला ये सब भाषा में विद्वान, और आपने हमारे जैसे मूर्ख कोई नहीं बोलते। तो यदि ऐसा है उन्होंने जो बोला ये झूठ बोला, जो जितना ऊपर में जाएगा उतना ही दीनता आएगा। तो ये महाराज जी दीनता करके बताते हैं, धनी लोग बोलता है हमारा बहुत धन है, तो और बड़ा धनी का तरफ निकाली भी, यदि हम लोग श्रेष्ठों का तरफ ध्यान दें तो हम लोगों का कुछ बहुत कुछ मिल गया,
ये अभिमान को भी आएगा, दीनता ही आएगा। कैसे मांगे श्रेष्ठ संग करने से होगा। चैतन्य बोला घृणा लोपी सुनी चेनो तरुणी वो सही सुनना अमानिना मान देनो कीर्तनियो सदा। ये खूब सहज बात है, श्रेष्ठ संग करने से दीनता अपने आप आ जाएगा। पिता का पास रहने से मैं पुत्र हूँ, और पुत्र का साथ नेगा दे के बात करो तो मैं पिता हूँ। व्यक्ति एक ही है, इसमें अभी जितना श्रेष्ठ संग करेंगे उनको इतना दीनता आएगा, और जो श्रेष्ठ संग नहीं करेगा इनमें दाम्भिकता होगा। भाई हमारा पूरी मन में एक आदमी वो यहाँ मच्छी रखता था और जड़े जड़े आवाज करते थे तो सब लोग भयभीत होता। तो हमारा एक ब्रह्मचारी बोलता है जब मठ में इतना दिन रहते हैं प्रसाद खाता है इसी को काट दो हरिनाम करो तो बोलता है तो काम करा जाएगा नहीं। उसका घमंग लेके काम कराने पड़ता है। तो उसी में भी जितना निम्न संग करेगा उतना लंबी होता आएगा, श्रेष्ठ संग से दीनता आएगा। ऐसा शिक्षणीय विषय आचरण करके शिक्षा दिया। अभी कृपा सिंधु
महाराज ने बहुत सारा बोला।
The very first thing Shila Maharaj started mentioning is that today is a very special day, auspicious day, the appearance day of Sri Srimad Bhaktivedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj. So, in the beginning, Srila Maharaj remembered that the time when Srila Gurudev, he was living in Mathura, from there, for some time, for some special reason, he was residing in Giriraj Govardhan, the same place where he established Giridhari Gaudiya Math afterward. Earlier he used to live there. That place was double story and Srila Gurudev used to live in the first floor. At that time Srila Gurudev wrote a letter to Srila Maharaj that I am in Govardhan in these days. If it is possible for you, you can please collect Sri Ujjwal Neelamani as well as Sri Bhakti Rasamrit Sindhu. These two scriptures, books written by Srila Rupa Goswami Pada. Srila Maharaj mentioned that in those days, these books were not easily available. It was out of print for a long time. So, because he wrote me, so that's why I was searching these books in many shops where we can even find old books, old publication. So somehow I found those two books and sent for our Gurudev. Srila Maharaj was speaking once in Bangalore. Our Srila Bhaktivedanta Vaikhanas Goswami Maharaj's place. And in those days Srila Maharaj was mentioning that how from the very beginning he had this impression from our Gurudev that how much attached he was for the writings of Srila Rupa Goswami Pada. That's why he wanted to collect each and every book which was written by Srila Rupa Goswami Pada. After that, Srila Maharaj mentioned that our Gurudev, he was living in Mathura from the very beginning almost. Our Param Gurudev gave him responsibility for Sri Keshav Ji Gaudiya Math. So that's why he was living in Braj. But Srila Maharaj, because he was busy in many other services given by his Gurudev, Srila Bhakti Dayanand Madhav Goswami Maharaj, but the time when they acquired land for Sri Chaitanya Gaudiya Math in Vrindavan, at that time Srila Maharaj also lived for a long time in Braj for constructing that math. So in those days Srila Maharaj mentioned, I got more and more close to Srila Narayan Goswami Maharaj. In those days, we used to meet in different occasions, different functions, and that's why we had more and more exchanges. And then Srila Maharaj mentioned that one time he visited me with Tamal Krishna Maharaj from ISKCON, disciple of Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj. And then Srila Gurudev, he introduced to Maharaj that, oh, this person is Tamal Krishna Maharaj. At that time, Srila Maharaj mentioned that I informed him that, oh, I know him from a long time. Why? Because when I was in Hyderabad, at that time, he also came one time. He also came one time in Hyderabad for preaching, and they were living in a hotel in Sikandrabad. In Saraswati Hotel in Sikandrabad. So Srila Maharaj remembered that how he came in contact with Tamal Krishna Maharaj. That's why he mentioned that, because he did not mention his name while he was speaking katha, but afterward he mentioned that that person has left his body now in one accident. So Srila Maharaj mentioned that how once he was preaching Tamal Krishna Maharaj in Hyderabad, and over there at that place, what happened that in one of his speech he mentioned that those people who don't observe Krishna Bhakti, who don't perform Krishna Bhakti, they go to hell. And his speech was being printed in a newspaper, and one of the Shankaracharya from Puri's Shankaracharya, who was there in Hyderabad at that time, Nishchalananda, he opposed him. Niranjan Dev Tirtha. So he was very much upset, and he also wrote against that, how you can say that. Like our prescribed duty is being mentioned in the Vedas, but the Muslims, whatever is written in Quran, they follow that. Christians, whatever is written in Bible, if they follow it properly, does it mean they have to go to hell? Or Krishna, he himself is mentioning in Bhagavad Gita that there are different kind of people who go to, some people go to Pitri Loka, some go to Swarga Loka and some other people they go to other places. But he did not mention that whoever not worships me, he only goes to hell. So how you can say that everybody will go to hell, those who don't worship Krishna? So he challenged Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj also in his speech, that I challenge his guru even, that he can come and I want to have debate with him. Srila Maharaj read all these things in the newspaper in Hyderabad. And then with one of his god brother, Dhira Krishna Prabhu, who was in charge of that mutt at that time, he took him and visited Tamal Krishna Maharaj in the hotel, found out where he is living, and then visited him and showed him the news cutting, that you are aware of it? Then he said, yes, I am aware of it. Then he showed one reply which he was writing with the help of one Ramanuji Vaishnava. And then Srila Maharaj also, Srila Maharaj liked that whatever they were writing, and Srila Maharaj also supplied some points from himself. Srila Maharaj mentioned that as soon as I read that he is challenging Srila Swami Maharaj, it made me feel like I must go and say something against this Shankaracharya. So that's why Srila Maharaj also gave him some points that yes, even though externally, if we go for world jugglery, I may be wrong that everybody will not go to hell. But in the real sense, because each and everything in this 14 planetary system, avirinchadapi amangalam, up to 14 planetary system, everything is inauspicious. So for devotees, does not matter. A person may be promoted to any other place except hell, but still that is also hell. But the external vision is different. For you, maybe Swarga Lok, heavenly planet, is different from hellish planets. But for devotees, heavenly planets are also hell. Why? Because that's also the punishment of Maya. But a person thinks in his mind that he is happy at that place and in hell he is suffering. But in reality, Maya is making both of them suffer, making those people who are in the hell suffering, like not giving them any eatables, not giving them anything for their sense enjoyment and suffering. And on the other hand, in the heavenly planets, supply them more and more things and ask them to eat more and more. When they stop, immediately they get also beaten by Maya. So in this way, Maya is punishing each and every person. So these points were being supplied by Srila Maharaj to Tamal Krishna Maharaj at that time. And then this Shankaracharya, he wrote back that, oh, because this person is Mallesh, he is a low caste person, I don't want to have any discussion with him. I want to challenge his guru. Then Srila Maharaj again supplied a point to Tamal Krishna Maharaj that you can ask him that first you can fight with the disciple. Then and only then we will consider call our Gurudev. You have to fight with us. Why? You can mention us that to which Shankaracharya you follow actually. Because Shankaracharya mentioned that each and every living entity is Brahma. So how come somebody is Mallesh or somebody is Hindu or somebody is this and that? According to our understanding, Shankaracharya says that each and every jiva is Brahma. So from where this point comes of Mallesh? So this point was also been spoken by Maharaj to him. And then this Shankaracharya completely kept silent. Afterward, Tamal Krishna Maharaj wrote this to his Gurudev, Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, who was in Russia at that time, and mentioned that how Srila Maharaj supplied these points, and Srila Swami Maharaj also appreciated that, oh, these points were very valuable. So in this way, Srila Maharaj remembered that how he met with Tamal Krishna Maharaj and Gurudev all together in Vrindavan and had many discussions in those days. And then the third thing Srila Maharaj started mentioning, that our Gurudev, he was following the footsteps of his senior godbrother, Srila Bhaktivedanta Vaman Goswami Maharaj. How after Param Gurudev, when there were prachar parties, like devotees from Devanand Gaudiya Math, they used to go for different programs, different preaching tours. Our Gurudev used to lead that. In Braj Mandal Parikrama, in Navadvip Dham Parikrama, Gurudev used to take all the devotees. Whereas Srila Vaman Goswami Maharaj, he used to stay back in the mat and he used to deliver his Harikatha in the evenings when devotees, they used to come back. So in those days, Srila Gurudev fully, he accepted the guidance of Srila Vaman Goswami Maharaj, and under his guidance, he was leading Prachar Party. The fourth thing Srila Maharaj mentioned, that how Srila Bhakti Pragyan Keshav Goswami Maharaj, our Param Gurudev, he was like a lion-like Acharya. He was unable to resist. Whatever comes in his heart, he used to speak it out. Does not matter how other people feel. Srila Maharaj mentioned two things today. One thing, that how he wrote, Savadi Sala Bhitte Galad. There is one ashram, Gaudiya ashram, they call themselves as Gaudiya in Savadi, a place Savadi. Over there is an ashram, Prapanna ashram. And they were writing something which was up Siddhanta. And Param Gurudev, he wrote back against it, that Savadi Sala Bhitte Galad means from in the foundation of this ashram in itself, there is something which is wrong. Why? Because the foundation of that society, that mission in itself, is the foundation in itself is having some problem in it. So how it is possible that whatever they speak, it will be accepted as bona fide? It cannot be accepted. And second thing, Srila Maharaj mentioned about Nimbark Sampradaya. When there was something like some debate, at that time Param Gurudev wrote such a word that we don't even accept. There is a Sampradaya which is called Nimbark Sampradaya. The word in itself is wrong because it is Nimbaditya Sampradaya. So Srila Maharaj mentioned that he was not having any kind of fear in his heart. So in the same way, our Gurudev, following the footsteps of his Guru Maharaj, he was also like that, fearless completely. There were certain points which Babaji, they stopped saying for many years. But as Srila Prabhupada disappeared, one by one his senior disciples, they disappeared from this world. Our Param Gurudev, he disappeared from this world. At that time, one person, Shyam Das, from Vrindavan, he's a like Hindi person, Punjabi I think. So he wrote so many books, translated so many books into Hindi. And he was the follower of Babaji and specially following Radha Govindanath, who wrote so many books in Bengali language. So he again came up with all those points which were being proved by Gaudiya Math, that all those points are bogus. But again he came up with that. So our Gurudev, again, he also acted as his Gurudev, lion-like Acharya, and refuted all the points which this Shyam Das and other Babajis were making at that time. And he printed it in the form of Prabandha Panchakam. Srila Maharaj earlier used to mention that how, while he was compiling those articles, five articles, at that time he used to consult Srila Maharaj also. And then they used to have discussion that, oh, we should write this point and we should not write this point. Srila Maharaj mentions that also. And then Srila Maharaj gave one point to him, point to our Gurudev, that we can ask this Shyam Das that he is following Radha Govindanath and saying that Gaudiya Math people, they don't have their Guru Parampara, proper Guru Parampara. So I want that we can point it out that who is the Guru of Radha Govindanath. Because Shyam Das considers that he is a bona fide person, that's why he writes his words, follows his words. But in reality, Radha Govindanath, he himself does not have any bona fide Guru. So what is his Guru Parampara? A person who does not have Guru Parampara, how can he ask or understand that what is the Parampara of Gaudiya Math? And then Srila Maharaj mentioned that this thing comes again and again. not only one time, at the time of Srila Prabhupada, also so many Babajis and so many other people, they used to say that Gaudiya Math is Vishwa Ninduk, means they are the one who always find fault in each and every person. Gaudiya Math people means they are always criticizing the whole world. For them, they are perfect and their philosophy is perfect, and other than that, nobody is bona fide. So they used to say like that. And the disciples of Srila Prabhupada, they used to prove that yes, we follow Bhagavad Dharma. And in Bhagavad itself, it has been mentioned very clearly that dharma name jato katha jagate chale. In this world, there are so many things which goes on the name of dharma. But in reality, what are those things? Bhagavat kahe taha paripurna chale. Srimad Bhagavat very clearly, it mentions that all those dharmas are known as the dharma of cheaters. They cheat, they don't do anything else. So that's why we have taken the responsibility to preserve, to present this Bhagavad Dharma, pure Bhagavad Dharma, nothing else. So this was the same concept which was being followed by our Param Gurudev, again by Srila Gurudev also, whenever the need arises. After that, Srila Maharaj mentioned that Srila Gurudev, for some time, he was manifesting his sickness pastime also. He was mostly having loose motions, dysentery. He was not going out even for preaching. So when Srila Maharaj asked him that, oh, once I was there in Jaipur, one devotee who was in contact with Srila Maharaj, who took initiation from my Guru Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, Sri Satyendra Bhan Chaturvedi, he asked Maharaj that, oh, in this place, in Jaipur, it's a place of Radha Govinda Dev. So many Vaishnavas, they visit this place. So many Prabhupada disciples, they came here and preached. But still, we don't have any congregation here. No prominent Vaishnav live here and come time to time. If somebody can come, it will be very good. So at that time, Srila Maharaj spoke with Gurudev that you are Hindi-speaking person. And Jaipur is a place where people can understand very easily your language. Why don't you go and preach over there? So at that time, Gurudev mentioned that I am having this sickness. I cannot go many places now. So then Srila Maharaj mentioned that how I took him to Kolkata. And over there, there was a doctor whose name was Dr. N. R. Sen. Srila Maharaj took Gurudev over there. And then for some time, Gurudev took treatment over there, and then he recovered. Slowly, slowly he went and to different places for preaching. And then Srila Maharaj mentioned that his contribution in book publication in Bhagavat Patrika, which was been started by our Param Gurudev. And then our Gurudev, he was the person who took charge of this magazine, took all the responsibilities on his head. In that Bhagavad Patrika itself, he printed part by part Jaiv Dharma and Chaitanya Shikshamrit and different other books. And once it was completed in Bhagavad Patrika, then it was printed in the book form. So this also Srila Maharaj mentioned that afterward, he translated so many books into Hindi languages, and then those same books were also been printed and translated into English and other languages also. So this is also his main contribution in Gaudiya line. And then Srila Maharaj mentioned that how Srila Gurudev, he started preaching in the Western world. At this point, Srila Maharaj mentioned that even though 100,000 people, they go to the Western world, they speak so many things. But still, a person who is having proper conduct, a person who really follows the pure doctrine of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in his life, that person can transplant the pure teachings of Sriman Mahaprabhu in the heart of others. Many people can go, but it is not that they will be able to do that same work. But he was able to do that. Why? Because he himself was established in all those truths what he was preaching. when Srila Maharaj was speaking this, I remembered that how once Srila Gurudev, after his like his gallbladder was removed in Delhi, in Batra hospital, and Gurudev came back and rested for some days in Gopinath Bhavan. And Srila Maharaj came to meet with him at that place. And then in his conversation with Gurudev, Srila Maharaj mentioned to Gurudev that we pray to the Lord that you can live long so that people can have benefit of your presence in this world. At that time also Srila Maharaj mentioned him that even though before Srila Prabhupada extensive preaching, even though Chaitanya Charitamrita was there, all the scriptures written by Goswamis and Bhagavatam, everything was there, but still people were unable to understand the pure doctrine of Chaitanya Charitamrita. Why it was like that? Because to establish these truths, a person is required who follows all these things and whose conduct is proper. So in this world, people, those whose conduct is proper, are very less. So that's why we pray to the Lord that you live long. This was the conversation in Gopinath Bhavan. And then after that, Srila Maharaj mentioned that if I say that my relationship with Srila Bhaktivedanta Narayan Maharaj was like a bandhu, friend, that will be improper. Why? Because my relationship was much more than that, which can be called that we were bandhav. Then Srila Maharaj explained, I think in Govardhan also Maharaj was mentioning this, and today also Srila Maharaj mentioned in detail that who is called bandhav. Srila Maharaj mentioned this word is been used by gopis for Krishna. In Chaitanya Charitamrita it has been mentioned that gopis, they are mentioning Krishna. When Krishna, he left Braj, many years he did not came. When Uddhav came, and then they were having conversation with Krishna, when he saw that how Srimati Radhika, she is speaking with Bumblebee, at that time she is mentioning, Bandhav Krishna Kare Vyader Achar, that, oh Krishna, we always consider that you are our Bandhav. You are the one who protected us. You are the one who nourished us. You are the one who accepted in whatever way we were. You loved us a lot. But now you are the same person who are acting as hunter. Hunter, what he does? That he feeds the animal very nicely. He makes all those arrangements which animal likes. But when this animal comes close, at that time they shoot. So in the same way, you protected us, you nourished us, you loved us, but now you are acting as a hunter. So this was been used by gopis. So Srila Maharaj mentioned this word bandhav is very special. Sometime he mentioned that why our Param Gurudev gave this special title to our Gurudev, Bhakta Bandhav. Why? Because he was acting as a bandhav to all the devotees. That kind of simple, soft-hearted person he was. Bhakta Bandhav. So Srila Maharaj mentioned that he was my Bandhav also. Bandhav is a person. Who is that person? First Utsave. A person who always joins you in your happiness. Vyasane Chaiva. A person who is always there when you are in difficulty. Durbhikshe. He is also there with you when there is Durbhiksha. Means when you are in such a situation that even after begging, you are unable to fill your stomach, belly. At that time also he acts as your friend and always with you. And then Rashtra Viplave means when there is a fight, can say like a person is living in one society and then he is having some problem with his society itself. Like Srila Maharaj mentioned, earlier in Pakistan and India, it was one nation. But then it divided into two. So a person who is also there with you when you are separated from somebody, from some institute, that person is known as Bandhav, Rashtra Viplave. And then Raj Dware. Raj Dware means like our Param Gurudev. He was been accused. He was been put into jail also. But those who were his Bandhav, they did not disbelieve him even in those situations. They did not consider that, oh, because he has been put into jail, that's why he has made some wrong thing. I should not support this person. No. Like Srila Vaman Goswami Maharaj, he, even though he was young, but still, he did not lose faith at all when our Param Gurudev was put into jail. Why? Because he was having such kind of deep relationship. So this is called Raj Dware Shamshane Chaiva. At the end, when a person, he left his body, even at the place when Samadhi is being given or cremation place, that person comes over there. So a person who is there in each and all these kind of circumstances, that person is known as Bandhav. So Srila Maharaj mentioned our relationship was not only as a simple friend. Our relationship was like a Bandhav. And then next thing Srila Maharaj mentioned, that how he gave example that in Kaliya Dava, in Vrindavan, there is a mutt, Vinod Vani Gaudiya mutt, which was been established by Bhakti Sarvasva Giri Maharaj, Giri Goswami Maharaj, who was the disciple of Srila Prabhupada. And afterward, this mutt was been handed over by Giri Maharaj itself, so Srila Bhakti Dait Madhav Goswami Maharaj. After Srila Madhav Goswami Maharaj's disappearance, there was a dispute with local people. And local people were very strong. And they were attacking the brahmacharis in Vinodvani Gaudiya Mata. At that time, our Gurudev, he sent so many brahmacharis from Mathura to go over there, stay there, and show like that we are having also a big strength. Don't think that those brahmacharis who are living here, they are not strong. They don't have manpower. So Gurudev sent our like brahmacharis from Mathura, those who stayed there for some days, and then in their presence, the boundary wall was been built so that local people don't disturb the devotees in Vinodvani Gaudiya Mata. So Srila Maharaj mentioned that the devotees who were living there, even though all of them, they are from Sri Chaitanya Gaudiya Mata, they were having deep regard for our Gurudev also, for this special help which he made them at that time. That's why they used to always call Srila Gurudev for the disappearance day of Srila Bhakti Sarvasu Giri Maharaj. And Gurudev also used to go every year during the time of Julan. Again in Kartik also sometime. So in this way Srila Maharaj mentioned that he was always there to help whenever help was required. And then Srila Maharaj mentions about himself also that in Rup Sanatan Gaudiya Mata, now we see that from where we enter from this gali, main gali ko kya kehte hain? Seva Kunj Gali. From here, I think the devotees like our Singhanyaji is definitely, and Rohini Prabhu also, Padmana Maharaj, all these devotees, Jaldar Prabhu, they know very well that this gate which we have now on the entrance, on the road itself, it was not there earlier. That place was not belonging to Rup Sanatan Gaudiya Mata. But Gurudev always, because it was such a place that local people, they used to disturb a lot. Whenever our devotees, they wanted to enter into Rup Sanatan Gaudiya Mata, they always used to throw their garbage, and so they used to like make a mess over there. But afterward, Srila Gurudev, he asked Maharaj that what should be done for this thing. Then Srila Maharaj suggested him that it is better that we can buy this place, even though it is costly, but it will give a great relief for the devotees who will be coming to Rup Sanatan Gaudiya Mata. So then Srila Gurudev bought that place, and how to buy, Srila Maharaj also advised him and suggested him. And whenever Srila Maharaj mentioned that in Devanand Gaudiya Mata, when Gurudev wanted to construct this Dharmashala, at that time, even though they submitted like a plan to the municipality that they want to construct this building, but then Srila Gurudev, he asked Maharaj that we want to construct this place, but the plan is taking long time. They are not passing this plan. So what to do? They are not approving it. So at that time Srila Maharaj advised him that you have submitted the plan. It is not that they can cancel it because land belongs to you. they can only change the plan. So you can start acquiring the cement. Just on the basis of this plan itself, you can go and acquire the cement. Get the cement. Because in those days, cements were not easily available. It was also under control. So Srila Maharaj helped Gurudev in different other things also. So after that, Srila Maharaj mentioned that how Srila Gurudev, he was having one more sentiment for that Vinodvani Gaudiya Mata. Why? Because when our Param Gurudev, we hear that one time his god brother came on the day of Ekadashi, Param Gurudev in his heart, he was having this desire to serve him.
नारायण परम गुरु जी के भक्ति प्रज्ञान केशव गोस्वामी महाराज जी के पास में कौन से उनके गुरु भाई आए थे जिनकी वो सेवा करना चाहते थे?
नारायण
मुखर्जी.
सो वन ऑफ हिज गॉड ब्रदर नारायण मुखर्जी ही केम टू हिम. परम गुरुदेव वांटेड टू सर्व हिम बट ही वाज हैविंग नॉट इवन अ सिंगल पैनी विद हिम एट दैट टाइम एंड नथिंग वाज देयर इन द मठ इन द प्लेस वेयर ही वाज लिविंग. So at that time what happened? A miracle happened. One bird came and dropped a small like cloth in which Param Gurudev found some paisa and then he served his god brother. And immediately after that particular incident on the same day, our Param Gurudev received one money order of 100 rupees which was being sent by Bhakti Sarvasu Giri Maharaj from Burma because he heard that Vinod Bihari Brahmachari, he left the mutt and he did not took anything with him. He is not having anything with him in these days. So he was preaching in Burma at that time and he sent 100 rupees money order to our Param Gurudev. So our Gurudev, when he heard about this Vinod Vani Gaudiya Mutt, which was been established by Bhakti Sarvasu Giri Maharaj itself, so this sentiment also made him feel that, we should send everybody over there for help. And then Srila Maharaj mentioned that how one time Srila Maharaj was there in Keshavji Gaudiya Mutt with our Gurudev and there was a like disappearance day of our Gurudev was being observed over there. Srila Gurudev, he was having this conduct that whoever is been invited on that day, whoever automatically appeared on that day, unless and until everybody is been fed, Gurudev would not take anything. Such was his conduct. So Srila Maharaj mentioned that one time I witnessed that also, that everybody was being fed nicely and then we were about to take prasadam. Our plates were also being served. I was supposed to sit with him for taking prasadam. But at that time, what happened, that one disciple of Srila Prabhupada, whose name was Sri Bhakti Prapan Damodar Maharaj, he came there. And Srila Gurudev immediately got up and received this Maharaj, asked him to take prasadam, but he said, I have to take bath first, then and only then I can take prasadam. And then Srila Gurudev asked Maharaj, that Maharaj, I may take maybe half an hour more. You can please take prasadam because plate is being served. But then Srila Maharaj mentioned that why it is like that. So then he mentioned that unless and until everybody takes prasadam, especially on this day, special day, how can I take prasadam? So then Srila Maharaj mentioned that I also said, we can take together. I can also wait. What's the problem? So then first Damodar Maharaj came, he took prasadam and then Gurudev and Maharaj, they sat together and took prasadam. And then Srila Maharaj mentioned that what kind of conduct he was having, that wherever he was being invited by the devotees, but to speak of the disciples of Srila Prabhupada, he mentioned two examples, that once he was being invited by Srila Bhakti Kumar Sant Goswami Maharaj, and on the another occasion he was being invited by Srila Bhakti Vaibhav Puri Goswami Maharaj. Because they invited him, so he went over there with some devotees. He went to Vishakhapatnam and Srila Bhakti Vaibhav Puri Goswami Maharaj invited him and he went to Kolkata when Srila Bhakti Kumar Sant Goswami Maharaj invited him. So he was having such kind of feeling for the devotees that whoever used to invite him with love and affection, he always used to accept their proposal and used to go there and definitely contribute in his services also. And then Srila Maharaj remembered that how in Vishakhapatnam they were together in Srila Bhakti Vaibhav Puri Goswami Maharaj's like mutt established by him, did the installation ceremony. And after that, Srila Gurudev, he mentioned to Maharaj that Maharaj, Srila Maharaj asked him that, oh, what is your program after Vishakhapatnam? And then Gurudev mentioned that even though by hearing that you, Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhakti Jardhan Goswami Maharaj, all these devotees, all are going to Jagannath Puri from Vishakhapatnam. I also desire that I can also go to Jagannath Puri. But in Nilachal Gaudiya Math, the kind of facilities which are there is not suitable for my health at this time. I may fall down in the bathroom here and there. So that's why I am reluctant to go there. At that time, Srila Maharaj mentioned that, oh, Maharaj, you can come to Sri Chaitanya Gaudiya Math and stay there for some time. What's the problem? And Srila Gurudev happily accepted that, oh, if that is possible, then definitely I want to go. And then Srila Maharaj mentioned one thing, that at that time, what happened, that even though my reservation was after 2 days, I was supposed to travel with Srila Bhakti Jivan Janardhan Goswami Maharaj and Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj. My ticket was reserved and everything was already planned. But as soon as I heard that Maharaj is desiring to go to Puri, I left before 2 days without reservation. Why? Because when I came to Jagannath Puri, what I did, I removed all my stuff from my room to the in a room where there is no attached bathroom facility, and left my room empty, made it empty for our Gurudev to come and stay there. So Srila Maharaj mentioned that why I did that, because if I will be removing everything in front of him and asking him to stay in my room, then he will not be happy. So without mentioning anything, without letting him know that he has to stay in my room, I came earlier and removed everything. And in this way, I got opportunity to serve him, and he was merciful to me that he accepted that service from me. And then Srila Maharaj actually mentioned everything today in so many details. Maharaj, 5 minutes or less. 5 minutes. And then Srila Maharaj mentioned that how one time our Gurudev, he wrote a letter to Srila Bhakti Dait Madhav Goswami Maharaj mentioning that a group of devotees from Gaudiya Vedanta Samiti, they are here in Mathura. We want to come to Vrindavan and I want to take them for darshans in Vrindavan everywhere. We may have to stay for some days. If you people can allow us to live in Sri Chaitanya Gaudiya Math itself, because they are having guest house also. So if you people can allow us, then we can make our program accordingly. When Srila Madhav Goswami Maharaj received this letter, he wrote back that it's our great good fortune that if devotees, they want to come and stay with us. But we have one condition. The condition is that at this place, there will be only one fire for cooking. We will not allow any one of you to cook separately. If you people are agreed with that, whatever we serve you, as well as your party, you people will happily accept. Then and only then, you people are welcome, otherwise not. And then Srila Gurudev happily accepted this, and they came and stayed in Vrindavan, Sri Chaitanya Gaudiya Math. Srila Maharaj mentioned at that time, his Guru Maharaj mentioned him that a special opportunity has knocked at our door. A chance to serve Vaishnavas has come. We should make best use of it. And then Madhav Goswami Maharaj mentioned him, today Maharaj is mentioning, that he mentioned him that if anything comes in your mind except about renunciation, about austerity, that is for you. You can always keep in your mind that if you want to be renounced, if you want to austere, that is for you. But for Vaishnav Seva, never ever think that, oh, they are also like Tyagis, they are also renounced people, so we can give them whatever we want. No, for their service, all best effort should be used. So in this way, Srila Maharaj remembered this and then remembered our Gurudev, that how once Srila Gurudev was in Haridwar, again in one branch of Gaudiya Vedanta Samiti. So at that time, I was also there personally, but Maharaj was being informed about this incident by one of his god brother whose name is Tapaswi Maharaj now. Earlier his name was Bhudhari Prabhu. So this Bhudhari Prabhu, he came to Haridwar Math and he was there with four or five devotees only. And then our Gurudev, he saw him that he was cooking separately for five devotees. And then Gurudev asked that, why you are cooking separately? He said, because devotees who are living here, they are very less in number. It is difficult for them to cook. So that's why they asked us that we can cook separately. And then Gurudev called the mutt in charge over there. At that place, whoever was in charge, Gurudev called him. And Srila Maharaj used one word, that sharam nahi aati. You people don't feel shy at all. That how you people can say that, oh, they can cook separately. When we visited Srila Madhav Goswami Maharaj, he did not allow us with our full party that, oh, we cannot cook separately. And there are only five people, why they have to cook separately? So Srila Maharaj mentioned that this particular conduct which my Guru Maharaj showed to our Gurudev through letter, Srila Gurudev kept it in his heart and followed deeply. And when the time came, he also showed that he chastised that, no, we should follow that same standard. That, oh, only five people have come, only these devotees have come, why we cannot serve them? So Srila Maharaj mentioned that kind of conduct he was having. He was fearless to speak anything and everything to anybody and everybody. Whatever was right, he was not fearful to speak. But then Srila Maharaj, in lamenting, he said that, oh, nowadays everything has changed. Those days has gone. Those kind of conduct, that kind of conduct is not visible anymore. And then Srila Maharaj appreciated that how our Gurudev, even though he was, the time when he started traveling to the Western world, it was not that he was young at that time. He was on the risk of his health. Even he traveled, that kind of strong desire for preaching the message of Mahaprabhu was there in his heart, that he took all risk of his health and went to many places and preached everywhere. And then Srila Maharaj mentioned the mutt, wherever he established mutt, in Navadvip, in Govardhan, he chose to have a big place. Why? Because he accepted he adopted that particular conduct also from my Guru Maharaj, from Srila Bhakti Daita Madhav Goswami Maharaj, who used to say that if we get small place, we don't want. If we get big place, then and only then we want. Why? Because we are not Bhajnanandis, that we want only place for one or two people. We are Goshtanandis. We want that, we are having this feeling that we are very weak. We cannot perform bhajan by ourselves. That's why we need a group of devotees who can live with us, make us feel more and more strong to follow the path which has been shown by pure devotees. So that's why Srila Maharaj mentioned, with this concept, he also acquired a big land. And then Srila Maharaj mentioned at the end that how Srila Trivikram Goswami Maharaj, Gurudev, they came to Jagannath Puri and they were going from one place to another. Srila Gurudev asked Maharaj also, they came to Jagannath Puri. They came to Jagannath Puri and then Srila Gurudev used to take parikrama party. And he asked Maharaj also that you can come and join us also. So Srila Maharaj also joined them in many places. So Srila Maharaj was remembering that how in Tota Gopinath, one time, Srila Trivikram Goswami Maharaj spoke first and then he mentioned out of his natural humility that, oh, I have performed many parikramas in Braj, in Navadvip, in Jagannath Puri, but I see I am not benefited at all. So he just spoke like this and then stopped speaking Harikatha. Then Gurudev, he told Srila Maharaj, he asked Maharaj, that Maharaj, now you can speak. And at that time Srila Maharaj mentioned that out of his natural humility he is speaking like this. Nobody should be feeling like discouraged that what is the use of performing parikrama. He is having such a high concept like Rupa Goswami, like Kaviraj Goswami, because they were associating with higher devotees. That's why they were having this feeling. Rupa Goswami mentions about himself, Adhar Apyo Paradhanam, means I am such a person that whatever comes from others, whatever dirty thing comes from others, I take into my ear and keep in my heart. I am like a dustbin. Adhar Apyo Paradhanam. This is my situation. So Srila Maharaj mentioned that this was being spoken by him out of his natural humility. About Kaviraj Goswami, he mentioned that who am I? I am smaller than the worm in the stool. I am more sinner than Jagai and Madhai. But these words are like, it shows his natural humility. That how? Because he was having higher, he's looking each and everything with a vision. Like he's seeing how Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, they are having their conduct. And how low I am. With this concept, natural humility appeared in his heart and he was speaking like this. So Srila Maharaj mentioned, Trivikram Goswami Maharaj also speaking with it, that concept, it should not be considered that he is not really benefited. Like a wealthy person, he never accepts that he is wealthy. He just says that, oh, somehow or other, everything is going on. But he does not accept that he is wealthy. So in this way, Srila Maharaj mentioned all these things and I tried my level best to explain everything. Vancha kalpitarubhyascha kripa sindhubhyo patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo.